NYWC, I am the administrator of the NYWC message board, Robert Lottie. Going the Distance 2018 was a great show, and definitely was so glad to be back in the sportatorium. That 6 weeks from Master of the Mat up until Going the Distance felt like a darn eternity. We begin the show with Well, right before the matches got underway, we see John Kerr, Shane, Apollyon, Matt Stryker, and members of the late Neil Swenson's family in the ring. And Shane felt it was time to honor Neil, and they added Neil Swenson way, into the, I guess it's a wing of the NYWC Hall of Fame. And it was, the man's definitely missed, and I do remember him when he was doing security and helping out at the door many times at numerous NYWC shows in the past. So, nice way to honor him. The action begins with tag team action as Alvin Alvarez and Kota are in the ring and they're weighing their opponents. And out comes Crusher Doogan, who was inducted into the aforementioned Hall of Fame just last month. And Doogan announces that, I forgot what he said, but he announces that, his, I guess his latest charges, and out comes a tag team. I didn't get their individual names, but they're collectively known as Damage Incorporated. And the match was on, and Damage Incorporated defeated Alvin Alvarez and Kota to pick up the victory. Up next was a four-way matchup which saw the extricated Aiden Bale defeat Man of Steel Mike Verna, Angelo Andrews, and Tyler Murphy. Next up was tag team action as we saw Tara Calloway and Joey Conway defeat Matt Stryker and Tinder Tom. I don't know, is Tinder Tom going to keep teaming with Stryker or keep teaming with the man bun Jesus Johnny Radke? Next up in singles competition, representing the rep, Brandon Watts, he defeated the desolate one, Rex Lawless, in a great matchup. Next up we saw Jaden Vallow of the Punk Relics defeat Johnny Radke, the man bun Jesus, in a great singles matchup. After, as both men got up, the lights in the sportatorium go out, and out comes the demonic juggernaut Apollyon's in the ring, and he attacks both men and leaves them and laid waste to both of them. Next, it was scheduled for the cuffed and caged match, which saw, actually, Leo Blackstone was carrying Irish to the ring, and he had like a big container of water. Michael Mestrez got a toaster, and he plugs it into an extension cord, but out comes Jay Red, with the end of the extension cord that's normally plugged into an outlet, and thankfully they stopped the prevented Irish from getting electrocuted. And this was one wild and crazy matchup which saw the use of a baseball bat with barbed wire. I forgot who swung it, and let's just say the barbed wire was was deep to right field, shall we say. And I did see a fan with it after the show was over, that barbed wire that broke off the bat. Then, as the match went on, eventually, yeah, I forgot what other weapons were used. Sorry, folks, it's all, most of this stuff is a dang blur. I can't keep track of every bit and piece. I'm not Mike Johnson of PWInsider.com. It's fucking hot out here. But eventually, Jay Red hit a Van Terminator off the top rope onto a trash can in the faces of both Mastretta and Blackstone. Actually, he was in the face of Mastretta in the end, because Blackstone eventually got handcuffed to the cage first, and then Mastretta was cuffed, enabling Jay Red Irish to win the matchup. And as a result of a pre-match stipulation, Michael Mastretta and Leo Blackstone must now leave NYWC. And I remember Shane and Bull James come to the ring, hugging and congratulating, thanking both of them for all they've done and all the time they put in. And not surprisingly, they went to intermission after that. And we had, we had more tag team action as the Undressed Express, Anthony Lacerra, Jesse Vane, defeated Ultimo Maya and El Futuro. Pretty good match for this tag team, these two tag teams put on. Up next, we saw Mouse defeat the Rep's Chris Bishop to retain the Fusion Championship. Up next was a six-man tag, which was billed as a Shots versus Beers match, as the Beer Belly Bandits, JT Case and Spider, and Bo Pritchard did battle with the Private Party, Big Daddy Cruz, Isaiah Cassidy, or is it Kennedy, and Mark Quinn. Big Daddy Cruz can really go in the ring, even hit a Hurricane Rana on Bo Pritchard. At one point, I think the Private Party offered the Bandits some shots and asked the DJ to play some music, and LMFAO's Party Rock Anthem played, sadly, just before the lyrics came in. The party threw shots in the faces of the Bandits. Eventually, the Beer Belly Bandits defeated Private Party to pick up the win. Next up, we were scheduled to see the Flawless Blake Morris take on the Rancid One, Bam Sullivan, in a match to determine a number one contender to the Fusion Championship at Trust No One. Unfortunately, Flawless Blake Morris was unable to make the show, and the Rancid One, Bam Sullivan, the leader of the Extricated, he defeated yours truly, Alex Reynolds, who had Rick Cataldo in his corner. And by virtue of the victory, Bam Sullivan will challenge Mouse for the Fusion Championship at Trust No One, which is taking place, which will be the next show. Next, we're set to see the Benson Bros challenging the Rep for the Tag Team Championship. The match ended in a double countout. And then it was main event time as King Mega was set to challenge Bull James for the Heavyweight Championship. Before the match got underway, the King told Alex Reynolds and Rick Cataldo to leave the ring, kept saying, "Trust me." And they leave the ring. The match was on. Eventually, King gets his hands on the championship belt. He's about to hit Bull in the face with it, but he puts the belt, puts it down. He eventually hits Bull with the choke slams, gets the three count. King Mega becomes the new heavyweight champion, marking King Mega now his second time as heavyweight champion, as he held the belt dominantly from 2008 to 2010. And eventually, Reynolds and Cataldo come back out congratulating King on the win, but out come the Rep, who are standing on the apron outside the ring, and Reynolds is looking to give Mega a hug for his victory, but Mega steps back and leaves with the Rep out the back. Ugh. Fuck. Fuck, it's hot out here. Damn it. Okay. Yeah. So definitely a great night of action. Personal notes time, it was great seeing my favorite NYWCites, Leanne and Jessica. Great meeting Jessica's boyfriend, Sam. And great to see he enjoyed it and he will be back. My cousin Edward and his new girlfriend, Lisa. Great to, unfortunately for those two, they could not handle the heat. And they ended up like watching the show from outside by the back. And kudos to whoever opened up that garage door back there. Because even we had to go outside during intermission. It was so darn hot in the building. Great seeing Joseph DeBari, Vinny the Guido, whose son Vincent is now a referee in NYWC. James McGrady, John Kersh, Shane Forge. Damn, man, who else did I see here? Jim Lundis, how can I forget about that guy? Oh, what's going on with Jeff Cannonball? He hasn't been seen since April. I mean, is he done with NYWC? Bam, Victoria, Aiden, you might know the answer since he last was seen part of the Extricated. I did have to say, Beer Belly Ben, it's that logo on JT and Spider's gear, that would make a great t-shirt. And yes, I would buy it. I got to go to BK Grasso's after the show. Unfortunately, there was no karaoke there. Just a surprise party for John Kurz, whose birthday was recent. Fuck. Good thing I was sitting in the shade here. Jim Lundis, I appreciate you talking to me at the after party. I know it's very rare you would come to the after parties. Hey, Johnny Radke, you know, I wish I could find Mountain Dew USA. I mean, it's very hard to find, I suppose. Definitely want to try that someday. NYWC certainly has a loaded tag team division right now with the current champions, the Rep, the former champs, the Benson Bros, J-Red and Irish, Matt Stryker and Tinder Tom, or sometimes Tinder Tom and Johnny Radke, any two members of the Beer Belly Bandits, the Undressed Express, former champions, now Crusher Doogan's newest team, Damage Inc. Damn it. I gotta say, NYWC equals party atmosphere. No, we do have memorable quotes. What are you doing? Matt Stryker to Tinder Tom when Tom was accidentally wrenching Stryker's arm when Tom ended up seeing both Terakawa and Joey Conway in front of him. Who cares about karaoke? Jim Lundis at the after party. You may not care for karaoke, man, but you know, that was, I missed doing karaoke at BK Grounds, but unfortunately they didn't have it there on this occasion when I got to go. I'm let down, I did not get a picture with Jessica, Leanne, Sam, my cousin Edward and Lisa, because unfortunately Edward and Lisa, after taking me to BK Grasso's, they went off to Lindenhurst to see his former, the band he used to be a part of, perform. Shane, John, I'll get to that shortly, but considering how hot the building was, how about next June's going the distance? We go to, you run the show in a place that's air conditioned. And while on the subject of an air-conditioned building, NYWC presents Trust No One on Saturday, July 28th from the air-conditioned American Legion in Babylon, New York, which is walking distance from the Babylon train station, folks. So for those here in the New York City area like myself that can't drive, all you do is take the train and then it's a short walk. It'd be wonderful if a few members of the crew would make this show, namely a certain independent wrestling fan who's has been to, I think he's gone to more federations than I have in only the few years he's been following indie wrestling. And well, I mentioned about this very show, trust no one, we already have announced Mouse will be defending the Fusion Championship against the rancid one, Bam Sullivan. I would like to see the newly crowned heavyweight champion, King Mega, defend his championship rematch against Bull James. I'd like to see J-Red and Irish against the Undressed Express. That's me. Oh, man. Shoot. I don't know where high society goes from here now that King Mega is now a part of the rep. I'd like to see, Oh, actually, I'll get to that shortly, as far as BK Grossos is concerned, folks. Fuck. Brandon Watts is really on a roll here. I wonder what's next for him. I wonder where Ugo of the Punk Relics was unable to make the show, or if he's injured or not. Ah, man. Okay, I'd like to see Crusher Duggan's new tag team, Damage Incorporated, take on Ultimo Mayo and El Futuro. Don't know who we'd like to see Willow Nightingale face for the Starlet Championship. All right. Well, when I was at BK Grasso's... and Bob Grasso, great seeing you, man. I had the cheese quesadilla. It was great, but it didn't fill me up. Leanne, she had the chicken tender sub, and it was so big. I definitely gotta try that out when I pay BK Grasso's a future visit. And unfortunately, Leanne was unable to finish it. I got to dance with Jessica to Simply Red's Holding Back the Years. Well, you know, her boyfriend will be at the shows with us in the future. You know, at least I'm still having a wonderful time with Jess and Leanne. You know, they're such wonderful friends, and I don't know if I'd like to definitely dance with Leanne someday, but that young lady is shyer than me, folks, and she, I don't know why, but she spends most of her time looking at the phone than watching the show. I mean, folks, I know from experience that the phone can wait. And she's not on any social media website, so I don't know what she's doing on her phone all that time. But, you know, Going Distance, great show, and so glad to be back at NYWC, and hopefully my cousin Edward and his girlfriend Lisa will be back and for July 28th. I definitely, if it wasn't such a beautiful day out here, I wouldn't have come outside to do this. But, darn, what was I gonna say here? Okay, well, I'll definitely wrap this up and And definitely, you know, I sure can't wait for the next show. NYWC rules, folks.